one of the important benefits of becoming more educated about your finances and how to invest and having a plan for your future, one of the benefits of doing this at a younger age is, without regard necessarily to how your finances work out for you in your 40s, 45, 50, 55, meaning if you lose work or you make a bad investment, to the extent that you become better educated and better aware at a younger age, it does take off a lot of stress later in life. A lot of the stress that can come along with feeling like you're not making progress financially, that's one thing. But another factor is when you just feel ignorant about what you're doing. And that can be frustrating in many different ways, and like all different aspects of our personal and professional lives. So if you, as a younger person, even, you know, somebody, it's never too old to learn this stuff, but taking ownership of your finances at a younger age will certainly reduce stress. Another benefit, and I suppose this might go in the category of it goes without saying, I guess, if you get, become a better planner, have good understanding of the importance of saving at a young age, you'll just accumulate more assets. And that is without regard to whether or not you have a lot of money, however we're defining a lot of money, people making well in excess of six figures, to people that make much more modest incomes. If they live within their means and they can start saving on a regular, consistent, methodical basis at a young age, they're simply going to have more money in their late 40s, early to mid 50s, on into their 60s. And that's going to take some pressure off, take some stress off, and also might allow them more flexibility later in life as well. So there, those are a couple of benefits of starting at a younger age. And I suppose the final one I would mention, and again, this is overlap with the idea of taking, you know, of having less stress, because you have more, you have more ownership of understanding how to plan and invest for your future, is getting involved in this at a younger age just helps you become more educated about the financial services industry and how, I guess if I'm going to be really cynical, how they can take advantage of people, or just understanding how the financial services industry operates so you can become a good consumer.
Yeah. No, absolutely. That's a really good insight. And, you know, what I find a little mind-boggling, Mark, and I don't know if you can adhere to this or speak to it, you know, these sort of topics are not taught in a lot of schools, you know, and they're not taught, you know, if I think middle school, high school, for example, I mean, especially high school, I think would be really pertinent, you know. It would make a world difference, because I think this is kind of a habitual thing as well. It's kind of a learned thing. I mean, if you have good role models in your life at a young age and you learn how the importance of money and what investing means, I mean, that can make a world of difference throughout your whole life. But it's just not taught. It's not given a lot of credence, unfortunately. And obviously there's a lot of videos and information disseminated all over the internet where you could learn it on your own volition, but you would have to do that. I think it takes a lot of like natural instinct and will to want to do it. It should happen, but you know, I think we unfortunately learn too much later in life the importance of having to have had invested when we were younger, you know. So is there a way you think in general that could start as part of the educational process at a younger age in a way?
Certainly, you're correct in the sense that I'm not aware of any sort of a curriculum in you know, conventional education where this is taught. Now, many people do actually learn it in their family. Most Americans, and I think this may be the case in other cultures as well, are very funny about money within their own families, even amongst their, you know, from parents down to children. And then certainly with their siblings and their parents, you know, it's a little bit taboo, right, in many families to talk, oh, you make this much or you don't make this much, that we draw conclusions and judgments about people based upon their earnings potential. So money's a little bit off limits in a lot of families. As far as, you're right, I should maybe clarify. I think there are some some, you know, maybe in high school, there might be some teaching of investing classes, but just financial planning and understanding finance and how to put together a plan and how to understand this. That's not a normal, that's, I don't believe it's part of many curriculums in high school or college. You're right. There are a lot of resources that are available. A lot of books, my gosh, a number of books have been written on personal finance, but it is come down to many times the initiative of an individual to want to get more involved and to begin to seek out this, this kind of information. One of the benefits certainly of the web is the ability for people to more easily access, you're right, videos or online books, or at least know where to go shopping for books that will provide background for that. How does this, and certainly parents can play a role too in at least putting their kids in the right direction. If your question to me is how do we actually make it a bigger part of our, I'm not sure that I can give an answer on how this becomes more ingrained in how we raise people. I suppose this kind of, it's really a question of consumerism. Are you a good consumer of financial products? And part of that is being educated. And there are other areas too, you know, it's kind of interesting. I've always thought to myself that in addition to, you know, saying something like, we should teach our kids this, I suppose that's debatable upon who you talk to, but should we teach our kids how to shop for healthcare? I mean, you know, like, I don't even know if I can, you know, how do I go? Do I price out to, like, what the cost of an outpatient clinic? Like, that's just like, it's a foreign concept to everyone. So yeah, it probably fits in the category where we could do that, but it's likely not going to be happening. At least that's my take on it. So yeah, it's up to the individual to get on it. Now, I can provide some ideas on things that I think are important for people to begin to learn about.